Hello friends, this video lecture contains how the timers are working in the ladder diagram for the completing any task with respect to time. In ladder diagram or a PLC, there are three types of timers are available. First is the on delay timer, off delay timer and return to timer. Let us start with the first type of timer is on delay timer. Here I have already built one ladder diagram for making coolant pump on after 20 seconds of starting motor. Means after motor gets start, coolant pump gets on after 20 seconds. That is the condition is given. To satisfy this condition, I have drawn this ladder diagram. This is the start switch. Let us make motor on. See here, coolant pump is not on. That coolant pump gets on after 20 seconds. When accumulation time is equal to or greater than preset time, the coolant pump gets on. See, coolant pump gets on after 20 seconds. Here I have drawn this ladder diagram for my coolant pump on after 20 seconds. You can draw ladder diagram for the various applications. Means you have to on certain things after some interval of time. You can use the on delay timer with timer done beat. Let us see next application. Here timer on beat is used, reset beat is also used. This is the start and stop switch on delay timer. Output is connected to the conveyor and this output is connected to the solenoid. If you look at here, direction control valve is fixed. This is the pneumatic operating system. This is the double acting pneumatic cylinder. This is the conveyor. Pulse gate down at the interval of 5 seconds. This is the double acting cylinder which is extending at the interval of 5 seconds. Let us see working. See, when accumulation time is equal to the preset time, punch gate direction control valve get activates and punch gate downs. This is the application of timer in the drilling or punching operations. Now this is the example for changing the railway tracks after a certain interval of time. It consists of, suppose this is a hydraulic system is connected to change the railway tracks. Cylinder A, cylinder B and cylinder C are connected to the railway tracks. I have built one ladder diagram. Let us see working. When you make the system on, cylinder A first get extend. Here time period is given. Up to that period, cylinder A get extended. Cylinder A retract after a certain period of time and B get extend. Cylinder B retract and cylinder C get extend. This all extension and retraction of cylinder is depending upon the what is the preset value is set for the timers. Carefully see the working, how the hydraulic system is behaves with respect to the times given to the timers. Let us see next function of off delay timer. Here I have made the ladder diagram for lubrication of motor stops after 10 seconds. Means when motor is stopped because of inertia, there is a running of motor for a few seconds. So in that period, the lubrication pump must be on for the few seconds. For that I have built this ladder diagram. Lubrication of motor stops after 10 seconds when motor gets stops. Let us see working for this. Press start switch, motor gets and lubricated, motor and lubrication pumps both gets on. When you stop, motor gets stopped but lubrication pump is on for the 10 seconds. To avoid the friction because of inertia of the motor, lubrication pump remain on for the 10 seconds. Next type of timer is the attentive timer. The application of this timer is whenever you stop the system, the time for which the machine is run, which is not counted by the other type of timers. So the attentive timer is nothing but which start counting from where you have stopped the system. Let us see working of attentive timer. This is the ladder diagram which shows the application of attentive timer, where motor and indicator is fixed. The preset value is set to the 45 seconds and time base which is selected is a 1 second. Means when accumulation value is reached to the 45 seconds, the indicator gets on. Let us see the simulation. Start the system. Now see accumulation value is start. When you stop the system, let's see. When you stop the system, accumulation value is stored, and when you make system again on, the attentive timer starts to count time from that onwards. The system stop at 40 seconds. When you make system again on, that will start from that time where it is stopped. That indicator gets on when accumulation time is reaches to the 45 seconds. Indicator gets on. The applications of attentive timers are like when the time of the any system is limited, that is lifetime of any system is limited, and you have to observe that how much time the system is running. After that, suppose you have to do maintenance of the system, you have to change some parts of the system. For that observation, you have to fix the attentive timer. Instead of indicator, you also fix the alarm when the system lifetime is reaches to a particular time, then alarm gets on. Like that you can make the many applications related to the attentive timer. Thanks for watching this video. To understand how PLC work, watch my next videos based on the PLC. Thanks.